start by talking about the difference between a marketing plan versus the marketing strategy, because I think that a lot of people get those confused, and understandably, because there's so much information out there about both of them. But the marketing plan, that is going to be your guiding principle, right? Those are really core pieces of your business that won't be changing so much, right? General guidelines and principles, and that is composed of marketing strategies, all right? So examples of that, your SWOT analysis, strengths, weaknesses, opportunities, threats, your marketing mix, product, price, place, promotion, right? So those likely are not changing too dramatically from year to year. Then there is the marketing strategy. So those are your longer term initiatives that you want to pursue, call them your goals. And then the actions you are taking to achieve them, campaigns, and the ways that you measure success, those are your KPIs. What are the elements of a marketing strategy? Well, there are a couple. One, your goals. You have to identify what it is that you want to accomplish and when you plan to achieve it. Your target market, so who are you going to be going after? Is that someone internally? Is that someone externally? Your self-audit, so evaluating where we are now and how far we have to go to reach that goal. Campaigns is how you are getting where you want to go, right? That's your plan of action. The tools, what you need to execute, and then your KPIs, those key performance indicators, which is how we measure success. First, setting goals. I'm sure that everyone has heard the acronym SMART goals: specific, measurable, attainable, relevant, and time sensitive, okay? And these are a couple different areas that you can be using for your goals, right? We talked about internal or external forces, so it could be your company. Maybe it's focusing on your customers, getting more customers, the tactics that you're using, processes, training, sales, things like that. The offerings that you have, either adding more or getting rid of ones that don't necessarily make sense with your brand, your advertising, and then, like we said, the sales cycle, training those salespeople. So we're primarily in this conversation going to be talking about your customers, your company, and then your advertising. Buyer personas. This is essentially identifying who's buying from you, right? Who are the majority of your customers? To identify those top customers by looking at your data and then writing down things that characterize them. You want to really bring them to life. So give them a photo, give them a corny name. Maybe it's choosy Charles, right? He has to evaluate a lot of things. You're going to be following up with him a lot, but in the end, he's going to be spending a lot more than, you know, some of your other customers, right? Age, gender, location, education, occupation. And you can find a lot of this information if you say, okay, I think I have an idea, but I'm not really sure. Maybe you look at the different sales, right? You take a look at your sales catalog, or you take a look at your social media, at the insights, who's looking at your page, engaging with your content. It's a really great place where you can get insights. And then the most important thing when it comes to your buyer personas is, what is their pain, and then how can you solve that? My first job out of school, great training program, and they told us, they said, what are you more likely to buy, a vitamin or an aspirin? It's the aspirin, because a vitamin is a nice to have, but if you have a pounding headache, you're definitely gonna go out and you're gonna get that aspirin. So make it a must have, not a nice to have. Understanding the buyer journey. So this is how someone goes from being a prospect to closing them and when they become a customer. The first stage is awareness. They have to recognize a need. So they identify that they have a problem, and then they enter into the second stage, which is consideration. That's when they begin searching for a solution. Maybe they are going on Google, or they're asking their family and friends for recommendations. They have to, you know, go out there and gather information. After, they will enter into the third step, which is the decision-making process. They're evaluating all of these different alternatives. They make a choice, they pay you, they become a customer. And the real question that we have as business owners is, how do we make ourselves stand out in comparison to our competitors, right? How do we get the deal instead of the other guy? Let's move on to self-audits. There are three main types of self-audits. There are your owned media, your earned, to have a comprehensive marketing strategy. So we're going to go into them individually right here. Your owned media. These are company assets that are under your control, right? I can change the copy on my website. I can add or delete people from my email list. My social media, I can post pictures or videos. Those are all things that are owned. You're going to create a list of all the different assets that you own under your control. You're going to see what is working for you and what isn't, and you're going to score it from 1 to 10. If there is something that's missing, maybe your competitor is using a different type of social media, or they have different tabs on their website that you don't, you want to be able to fill in those gaps and try different things. And again, identify how you're going to be solving that customer's pain with that. Earned media. This is buzz that is generated by a third party without compensation, right? So compensation is dipping more into the paid side of things, and we'll talk more about that too. Earned media are your backlinks when we're talking about SEO. So maybe I am a hotel and someone is quoting me in an article and they list me as a resource and they put a link that goes back to my website. It's also based off of your direct traffic when people are looking up your exact URL, your exact business, organic search, when they find you through different search engines, likes, comments, shares, and views. Those are all related to your social media. You have to determine what source of traffic has given